Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Anish Sir's Technology. So this is not a basically a continuation series. Today I'm going to discuss a new topic, that's a bootstrap. Okay, so just a moment, let's get started. Bootstrap, it's totally a practical approach. I will tell you what are the major basically use of bootstrap. Just a moment. Okay, see. So I have created one presentation slide. So let's get started with some theoretical points. After that, we will switch from theory to practical. Okay, fine. So Bootstrap was developed by Mark Otto and Jacob Thornton. You all must be aware about the Bootstrap concept if you are the student of web development. So you must have little bit knowledge of Bootstrap, but I will try to provide some more knowledge and more practical knowledge and more theoretical knowledge. Oh, step by step we will cover. So Bootstrap was developed by the Mark Otto and Jacob Thornton. These are the scientists. Ye wo scientist hain jinhone Bootstrap ko develop kiya tha. Okay. So you also know that something is front end and something is back end. Kuch cheeze aisi hoti hain jo hamari application ke front end mein work karti hain, and some technologies or some concept basically work in the back end. For example, if you talk about HTML, CSS, JavaScript, these are the front end scripting languages. Okay, if you talk about the ASP.NET, ASP.NET MVC, servlet, okay, or we can say that the PHP. So these are the server side scripting languages. So it is always used. I'm talking about Bootstrap. So Bootstrap is always used as a front end. So it is called the front end framework. Okay, it is the most popular HTML, CSS and JavaScript framework for developing the responsive website. What is the main purpose of the Bootstrap? Basically, the main purpose of the Bootstrap is to develop the websites which should be, must be responsive. Okay, so what are the responsive website? One second. Responsive websites are those websites which is adaptable and compatible with any kind of screen like tablet, mobile, desktop, big screen. Suppose I'm developing a website which can only run on my laptop or in my desktop, but it cannot run on the mobile or a tablet. So it will not be very much popular. Nowadays, a single website should be run, should be adjustable, should be compatible for every kind of screen. Okay, so that website are basically called the responsive website, and the Bootstrap is basically used to develop the responsive website. Hope you understand a little bit. Okay, it provides the faster and easier web development because there are a lot of ready-made classes are available inside this framework. Framework is generally means in which most of the things are already developed, only we have to integrate in our project and we can use. So bahut sare classes already Bootstrap mein pehle se bane hue hain, aapko sirf appropriate positions par un classes ko use karna hai. Okay, the official site of the Bootstrap is getbootstrap.com. ye wo site hai jisse hum contents download aur contents ko verify karte hain. Okay, one second. It is create the platform independent web pages, means each and every browser is compatible with the Bootstrap. Means suppose I am developing a website that can be run on the Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, or any other IE Internet Explorer or any other browser. Okay, fine, no problem. It is purely written in HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Okay, it creates the platform independent web pages. Okay, fine, this point is clear. Okay, before that, I want to clear one thing, and I want to show you the example exactly of the Bootstrap website. Okay. Fine, just a moment. I'm just taking the two example. One second. Suppose this page is appearing in the front of you. This is a Google page, Google home page. We can say that it is displaying and taking the complete width of the laptop or a desktop. Suppose I am shrinking this page. Main is area ko मिनिमाइज कर रहा हूं, रिड्यूस कर रहा हूं, तो रिड्यूस करने पर इस पर डिस्प्ले कंटेंट्स उसी मैनर में डिस्प्ले होने चाहिए जिस मैनर में ये इस टाइम पर डिस्प्ले हो रहे हैं. दिस इज द मेन डेफिनेशन ऑफ द रिस्पॉन्सिवनेस. जस्ट अ मोमेंट. नाउ सी आई एम जस्ट श्रिंकिंग द स्क्रीन सो यू कैन सी दैट लोगो इज प्रॉपरली कमिंग, सर्च एरिया इज प्रॉपरली कमिंग एंड दीज आइकन्स विच वर डिस्प्लेइंग एट दैट टाइम एंड इट इज डिस्प्लेइंग इन द सेम मैनर. सो दिस इज बेसिकली द मीनिंग ऑफ रिस्पॉन्सिवनेस. ओके, आई ऑल्सो हैव क्रिएटेड अ वेबसाइट, सो आई एम जस्ट वॉन्ट टू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट यू. ओके, सी दिस इज माई वेबसाइट बेसिकली डेवलप्ड इन द ASP.NET MVC. इट इज ऑल्सो अ रिस्पॉन्सिव वेबसाइट. ओके सी, so it is just displaying and taking the entire width of my laptop or a desktop. Okay, this is a menu and this is the options and these are the icons of the social media platforms. Okay, so I'm just clicking registration. So this is the registration page is opening and the user will fill the details, and after that the user will fill and this detail will be stored in the server. Okay, this is working. I'm just coming back. So this is the modal of the bootstrap. Okay, fine. Now I'm just reducing the size of the screen. So just a moment. So the size is reducing, but you can see that the menu is appearing. Okay, fine. And if I am clicking on the registration, suppose this is a mobile size, just for the assumption, suppose this is a mobile size. Now I'm opening my website in the mobile. Earlier I was opening the website in the desktop or a laptop, but right now I am opening the same website in the mobile. Ab hum isi website ko mobile mein open kar rahe. So I am just clicking on the registration. Okay, see. Now the user can fill the form in the mobile also. This exactly the meaning of responsiveness. So how the responsiveness is possible? By the bootstrap. Okay, so just coming back to the point. Okay, see. So how to start the bootstrap? So bootstrap, we can start by the two ways. Either we can work as a offline. What is the means of offline? We can download all the files related to the bootstrap from the official site getbootstrap.com, and we can, after downloading these files, we can include or incorporate in our basically project or a website where we are using the bootstrap. This is the first procedure. Okay, fine. This is not very much recommended procedure. Okay, the second is that we can use the CDN concept. CDN is totally a online concept. What is the full form of the CDN? Content Delivery Network. With the help of CDN, we can use the bootstrap. So CDNs are basically the links. These links are used to connect your present project to the bootstrap server. Understand? So with the help of, just a moment, I just want to demonstrate you a little bit diagrammatically. Okay, so this is your project, okay, in which you are going to develop a website on the base of bootstrap. This is your current website, okay, and this is the bootstrap server. Okay, so CDN basically create a bridge, so your website will be connected to the bootstrap server. Okay, fine. And you can use all the classes which are available in the bootstrap easily, no problem at all. Understand? So if you are using the offline files, no problem, you can use. But sometime what happens, upgradation is required. So every time you have to download the latest files and you have to include in your project. If you are using the CDN, I'm just explaining you in a comparison manner. Okay. The CDN, basically, if you are using CDN, so every time you will be updated. Okay. And the second advantage is that if you are using the CDN, always your project will be connected to the nearest server. So the performance of the application will be always very high. जब भी आप CDN यूज करते हैं तो आपका वेबसाइट, आपका वेब पेज क्लोजेस्ट सर्वर से कनेक्ट होता है. जो भी आपका क्लोजेस्ट, देयर आर सो मेनी सर्वर्स ऑफ द बूटस्ट्रैप. ओके, सो यू विल बी कनेक्टेड टू द क्लोजेस्ट और द नियरेस्ट सर्वर. फाइन. नाउ The second question mark is that how to get the file and how to get the CDN. Then we can start the bootstrap. Okay. So first level is clear and the second level is clear. Now how to get? For getting, always prefer the official site. Just a moment. So official site, just go to the Google. Okay. And just type get bootstrap. Only few words. Fine. Get bootstrap. Now you can see that this is the official site. Just clicking on it. Okay. And here you can download all the offline files. I'm just clicking on the get started. Here you can type CDN. This is a very, very important website for the bootstrap. So you will get most of the things from here. Okay, CDN. Just a moment. Now you can see that these are the CDN. So just you have to copy. There is a copy option. There is a copy option. Okay, just copy one by one and paste in a notepad. Okay. So I have already copied all these links and pasted over here. Fine. You can get these links in the description section of my channel. So you can get from there. So these are the basically CDN which you have to use. Okay. Fine. So I have collected the link. Second thing is that we have to clear a few things more. So second important thing is that which I want to cover, that is after downloading, we have to understand one thing. That is a container. Okay, what is a container? And the second thing is that the grids. These two things are very, very important, container and grids. What are the grids basically? Grids are the basically columns in a particular row. One second. Okay, slowly, I'm just covering. First of all, I just want to show the grid system I have created. According to the protocol and rule of the bootstrap is you can only create a maximum 12 columns in a row. Ek row mein aap 12 columns he create kar sakte. You know that horizontal are called rows and vertical are called column. You can make a row by 2 columns, 6, no problem. 6 plus 6 is 12. Okay. You can make a row by the 3 column and the width of every column will be 4. So 4 plus 4 plus 4 is 12. So maximum you can create the 12 column. Okay, fine. This is a major first rule of the bootstrap. How the column will be created, we will see practically, don't worry. So I'm just ignoring this section because this is an exceptional case in the middle. I will come to this point a little bit later. Now see this one, second last. I have just created the three width columns. The one column width is 3, the second column width is 3, the third column width is 3 and 3. So 3 plus 3, 6, 6 plus 3, 9, 9 plus 3, 12. So total must be equal to 12. You cannot go beyond this rule. आप 12 से आगे नहीं जा सकते. आपको जो कुछ करना है वो 12 कॉलम्स के अकॉर्डिंग ही करना है. यू हैव टू क्रिएट, यू कैन क्रिएट द मैक्सिमम 12 कॉलम्स इन अ पर्टिकुलर रो. दिस पॉइंट इज क्लियर. ओके, हाउ द रो विल बी क्रिएटेड, हाउ द कॉलम विल बी क्रिएटेड, वी विल जस्ट डिस्कस इन द लिटिल बिट. सो दीज रोज एंड कॉलम ऑलवेज प्लेस्ड इन अ कंटेनर. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल just a moment. So first of all, I will create a container. This is an area. Okay. In this area, we will place all the rows and columns. No limitation of the row. You can create the number of rows. No problem. If there is a big project, you can create the number of rows maximum. Whatever you want to create. But in a particular row, there may be maximum 12 column. Understand? So one second. Okay. So this is my container. How many types of containers are provided by the bootstrap? Bootstrap is basically provides two types of container. The number one is container Fluid, the number one is container. How they are different with each other, I will tell you. Only the spaces wise difference. Okay, so these points are clear. So this is a container. Inside a container, we can draw a row. Understand? Okay. And in this rows, we can create the columns. Suppose I am creating the two columns of the equal width. So the first column width will be 6. The second column width will be 6. Means 6 column, this is a 6 column. Okay, 12 column total. This area is occupying 6. This area is occupying 6. So 6 plus 6 is equal to 12. Just a moment. I am just creating one more row of 3 column. One second. Okay, this is first column. Equal division we have to create. The second column, this is the sixth, third column. So what will be the maximum width of this column? 4, 8 and 4, 12. Suppose we want to create the four columns. So accordingly, we have to adjust. We will see practically, no problem. Okay, so you have to keep this thing in the mind of the 12 column rule. Okay, no problem. Okay. After some time, you will be very much familiar about this concept. Starting mein thoda problem hoti hai. Theek hai? Hame bhi hui thi, sabko hoti hai. But after some time, you will be familiar with this concept. So in each and every row, you can only consider the 12 columns. Horizontal are called rows and the vertical are called column. Understand? Okay, fine. And each and every column must be placed in the container. So if we are using the concept of the CDN, I am just taking a fresh project, starting from scratch, zero. So I just want to create a folder, Bootstrap pages. Okay, fine. Bootstrap pages. I've created a folder. Inside folder, I'm just creating a file. Okay. FIRST first demo and extension, you know that each and every file HTML can only execute in the browser. Only HTML files can be executed in the browser. Okay. If you talk about the prerequisites of the Bootstrap, aapko kya kya cheeze pehle se aani chahiye? Okay. Number one, you must have the idea of HTML, hypertext markup language. Okay. Number two, you must have the knowledge of CSS. Cascading style sheet. And third, you can start Bootstrap after that. So you must have this knowledge. Aisa main maan ke chal raha hun. This is my assumption. Okay. But I am not going to use a very high concept of the CSS and HTML. Okay. Fine. So just right click. I don't want to run this file. If I will double click, it will execute in the browser. But I don't want to run this file. So just a moment, I'm just closing these files. One second. Okay. Again, I'm clicking, it will be run on the browser. Okay, fine. But I want to do some coding. So just a moment. For the coding purpose, you can use the Notepad. You can use the Notepad++. You can use the Sublime. Basically, I'm using the Sublime because it provides the better indentation and little IntelliSense support. Okay, so I'm just right clicking and open with choose another application. Here is the Sublime. Just click on okay. See, I'm just closing all the previous files. Fine. Okay, now it's okay. Now just type HTML. Okay. Because first of all, you have to create a structure or a skeleton. And the HTML provides the skeleton. Just tab, only tab, you have to press the tab. So basic tags will be created automatically. This is the functionalities of the Sublime. Okay, you can type also, no problem. Okay, so in the title section, I'm using the first Bootstrap. Project. Okay, or we have to include the CDN. So first of all, I have to check the internet connectivity is okay, or just a moment. internet connectivity is perfect. So in the head section, just place all these CDN. So just Control A, select all, Control C, copy, and paste over here. Understand? These are the CDN I have pasted over here. Okay. Now, in the body section, first I will create a division. Okay. So in the division, basically, division is basically used for the segmentation purpose. Aapki screen ko ye segments mein divide karta hai. तो डिवीजन बेसिकली एक सेगमेंटेशन के लिए हम लोग यूज करते हैं. ओके, सो डिव, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम यूजिंग क्लास इज इक्वल टू कंटेनर. अंडरस्टैंड, दिस इज माय फर्स्ट क्लास बिकॉज विदाउट कंटेनर वी कैन नॉट क्रिएट द रोज एंड कॉलम्स इन द बूटस्ट्रैप. अंडरस्टैंड? ओके. Now, inside class is equal to row. This is my first row. And okay, one second. Just a moment. First of all, I have to create a div. Because without div, I cannot create a column also. Division is very, very necessary. Class is equal to, okay, closed. So I've created the two divisions. One division, one segment is for container, the another division is for row. Okay, now one second. Okay, row is created, the container is created inside the row. Okay, if taking the example, okay, you can see that my first row is divided into two columns. Okay, column 6 and column 6. One second. I'm using the two class over here. The one class is container and the second class is row. Where is these class are defined? Basically, these classes are defined in the CDN. So you don't worry about that. These CDN will be taken care of all the classes. Okay, fine. So inside the row, div class is equal to call dash sm dash 6. Okay. And this is the division section closed. Again, div class is equal to call sm6. Okay. And this is the division. Okay, fine. So what I have done a very simple task. Just I have created a row. Just a moment. What I have done, basically I have created a row. I have created a row and the row is divided into two columns. This complete width of the row is basically called the 12 columns. Ye puri jo row hoti hai, ek row bootstrap mein wo 12 columns ki hoti. So if I am making the two columns, so obviously the first column will occupy 6 and the second column will be occupied the 6. So this column is 6 width and this column is again taking the 6 width. So two equal columns must be created. Okay, just a moment. I'm just clearing all this drawing. One second. Okay. Step by step, I'm clearing each and everything. I'm just saving this file. Now I'm running. Let's see anything. I'm very much sure anything will not appear on the screen. Okay. Blank page. See. Another blank page. I have done something, but it is not sufficient to display anything on a screen. So let's get back. Wapas. Coming back. So just a moment. What we have done? We have decided the width, but still we have not decided the height. Kisi bhi cheez ko screen pe display hone ke liye, height ke saath saath width aur width ke saath saath height ka hona zaruri hai. So how basically will provide the width? Width basically we have provided by the call sm6. It will occupy the 6 column width. Okay. Another column will take the 6 column. So total 12 columns are there, but the height we have to give. So how to provide the height? Just a moment. In the head section, we have to do the CSS for that. So in the style section, I am just creating one class dot represent the class height colon 50 pixel and the background color colon red, no problem. Okay. And dot second, this is my second class in which I'm defining height colon 50 pixel. This is the height and background color colon black. Fine. These two classes I have created, but we have to call these classes. Kahan pe call karna hoga? Yahan. Already one class is defined, call SM6 is a class. So apart from this, iske saath saath, we can also adjust my class. Understand? Just I am saving. And let's see, anything is displaying on a screen or not. So I'm just refreshing this page and double clicking C. Understand? Now it is the confirmation. It is a very important confirmation that we have started the Bootstrap. Link are properly working. Everything is on track. Now you see, this gap is creating from the left hand side and in the right hand side. These gaps are basically due to container. Due to this container. One second. So I've taken a class container. Okay. And I have explained you there are two types of container and container fluid. So basically, if we are using the container, it always leaves some margin from the left hand side or from the right hand side. These margins are basically due to the class container. I don't want this margin. I want to cover the entire width. No problem. We have to use the container FLUID fluid. Container fluid is basically used to take the complete area. Just a moment. Just click the cursor on the URL and press enter. Now you can see the complete area occupying. I want to leave some spaces from the corners. Hum nahi chahte ki bilkul adjust ho ke aaye. Hum chahte ki thoda sa margin, thodi si padding hamari browser se rahe. So that we can do by the CSS, no problem. Just a moment, just come over here. Body. In the body section, you have to define the padding 5 pixel. If you are a developer or a designer, you have to observe each and everything very, very carefully. Just a moment. Now see this design. Okay. Now this design is tightly fixed to the edges. Edges tightly fixed. Now I'm refreshing. Now you will see the difference. Minor difference is there, but difference is there. Okay. If you will increase this padding, you will get some more difference. One second. I am just refreshing. Fine. Understand? So I have created one row. It is divided into column. Let me check whether it's responsive or not. Every time we have to check because my main purpose is to make the website responsive. So how to check responsive? I am just okay. See, whenever we are just closing, जैसे मैंने अपनी स्क्रीन का साइज को कम किया, ये दोनों कॉलम्स स्प्लिट होकर के ओवरलैप करने लगे। इसका मतलब है कि हमारी जो वेबसाइट बेसिकली प्रिपेयर्ड हो रही है, that's absolutely responsive. Now the second, just a moment. Second, I have to create 1, 2, 3 columns. Okay, no problem. So we have to, what we have to do? We can create. Okay, so this is the parent division in which container fluid is designed. We have to do each and everything in this parent division. Okay. Now I just want to create if class is equal to row. This is my second row. In the second row, I am just going to create how many columns? According to the format, 3 columns we have to create in the second row. Okay. No problem. So div class is equal to call SM3. Understand? And we have to close div class is equal to call SM3. Okay. It's a very interesting subject. Okay. Div you will take the interest after some time. Call SM3. Okay, fine. So how many columns we have created? 3 columns, but the height and width I have not given. So we can, it's our choice. We can use these classes or we can create some more classes also. So I just want to create one more class, THIRD3. In this height, I've given the 50 pixel. And background color, light. Background color, light blue. Understand? So how many classes we have created? 3. So one class I will adjust with the first column. Second ke saath second and third ke saath. Understand? Just I'm saving. We have to be very careful while typing. Okay. Because intelligence support is not available with the Bootstrap. Okay. First, second, third. Spelling. You have to be careful about the spelling. Okay. In between, I want to share one more fact. Original name of the Bootstrap was Twitter Blueprint. Pehle iska naam Twitter Blueprint tha. Uske baad iska naam Bootstrap hua. So one second. See. Columns are 3, 3, 6, 3, 9. Okay. What is the problem is there? I have created only the 3 columns. One column, two column, third column. And I have not created the fourth column. Because if we are taking the 3, 3, so we have to create the 4 column. 3 each. So 3 plus 3, 6, 6 plus 3, 9. One more column we have to create. Or otherwise we can see the format. Basically format is saying that you have to create the column of 4, 4 width. So I have taken the 3, 3. No problem. So I'm just increasing the width. Then it will be set fully according to the just I'm saving. And in the browser, I'm running. Fine. Understand? Okay. The middle. Okay. Just a moment. See, these rows are very much closed to each other. See, these rows are very much closed to each other. So what we can do, I just want to create a little space between these rows. It's very little space. We can do, no problem. So how this space will be created? So just go to the first. There is a property in the CSS. Margin bottom is equal to 2 pixel. And just copying this property and pasting in all the classes. So after below the every row, if I will run, then you will better understand. Okay, see, this is the design earlier. Now see, this is the second design. Minor spaces there. Okay, now this is basically I've done for the separation point of view. Okay, separation point of view. If you will increase, then you will get the more difference. 3. And 3. These all depends upon our creativity. Jitni achhi aapki creativity hogi, utne achhi aur better design aap create kar sakte hain. Okay, now space is increased. Okay, 1 pixel space is increased. Okay, fine. Now just moving to the format. Now, this format, I'm just not touching this portion. Okay. So 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, we can create, no problem. 2, 2, 2, 2, we can also create. Okay. 3, I'm just want to create. So see the third section. In the third section, basically, I have told you number of time that only we can create the 12 columns in a particular row. But here we can see 6 column, then 4, 6 plus 4, 10, 10 plus 4, 14, 14 plus 4, 18. How it is possible? It is possible. First of all, I will create 2, 6, 6 column. Just a moment. Just concentrate on this example, third example. Okay, just a moment. In what I've done over here. First of all, here, I will create 1 second. 2, 6, 6 column, 6, 6 width columns. So this is the 6 column width. This is the 6 column width. So 6, 6 column width is created of the 2 columns. Now further, I will divide or split this column. Ye this column is created and further we can split this column. इस column को हम further split कर सकते हैं 12 column में further. Okay, this is 6-6. Understand? Just a moment. Yeah, because I am discussing a very important concept. 6-6. Understand? Okay. Now inside this partition. Okay, suppose your home is divided into two partitions. This is the width of first partition. This is the width of second partition. Further, you can divide these section again into 12 column. Understand? No problem is there. Okay, the rule will be applied over here. Understand? So after taking the 6 complete width, further we can divide into the 12 column. Understand? So what I have basically done in that section, I have taken the 2 6s column and the second 6 column is divided further into 4 4 4 4. Okay, I will show practically, then you will understand. Okay, see, so just a moment, one second. Okay, another row, div class is equal to row. Okay, and this is the row closed. First of all, I will create two partitions of the call sm6. Understand? And div class is equal to call sm6. Understand? And we can apply, just a moment, I want to take the fresh classes for these because the height of this is a little bit high according to the format. The height is a little bit high, so I'm just taking some other. Either we can take the classes in the style section or we can do the CSS over here also. Yahan par bhi hum CSS de sakte hain. No problem. Understand? So how? I will tell you in just a moment. But here I am just taking. COL call one. And height 100 pixel and background color colon green. Okay. And dot call two, column two, height colon 100 pixel, background color. One second. These two classes I am going to call in these two sections or column, call one and call two. Let me check the output, then I will change. One second. Okay, little bit more height I want. No problem, just a moment. Two hundred. Okay, fine. One second. Okay. Some parameters we have to decide on a spot. Fine. Now we have to divide this column. Just I'm taking a little bit light color. Fine. Understand? Now I want to divide this section. Okay. How many sections we have to further divide? Just a moment. I just want to see the format. Three. Okay. So no problem. I'm coming to the second column. Now see, basically this is the division of the second column. So in this, I'm just clicking enter over here. Now basically we are in the second column. Again here, we can create a row and this row can further divide it into 12 columns. But I want to only divide three columns. Okay. So just a moment. This is the row. Inside the row, div class is equal to call SM4. Understand? And this division, this is the first column. This call SM4 means, this is the first column I have created. Understand? Now, div class is equal to call SM4. One second. Div class is equal to call SM4. Understand? Okay. And this is the division is created. All the three divisions are created. Three columns are created. Only we have to adjust the two things. One is color and the second one is height. So height, basically we have to take the equal height, and the height will be, just a moment. So I have to take another call 3. Okay. Just a moment. Height, I'm just taking 200 pixel, and background color, light blue. Okay. And one second, call 4. I can repeat the previous, no problem. I will repeat, but this is the first example. So avoiding the confusion, I'm taking height colon 200 pixel and background color colon yellow. One second. And one more column, call 5. Separate classes I have taken. HEI height colon, okay, background color colon black. So call 3, call 4, call 5. These classes I can call in these three column. Call 3. One second. And here just I'm typing call 4. One second. And call 5. Understand? I'm just saving. Okay, saving and just going to the browser and running. See, three sections are created. This is section 1, section 2, section 3. Okay, understand? All the sections are created. Accordingly, this, the width of this section, just a moment. The width of this section is 6. This is 4. This is 4. This is 4. Understand? So 6 plus 4, 10. 10 plus 4, 14 plus 18. Basically, the calculation is 18, but logically it is 12 only. And you have seen what is the logic behind that. Okay, so hope you understand this is the grid system. And accordingly, if you do the practice, you will be expert in the grid system. So just a moment. Okay, see. So should I explain anything else? So this is a complete program. I will attach it in the description. Or these links I will also attach in the description. So I think the grid system is sufficient. In the next upcoming Bootstrap lectures, I will see or I will discuss some more important and interesting things. So stay connected with me. Just subscribe my channel and press the bell icon. Okay, fine. Okay, so I'm just closing this session. I have not. Okay, I have covered all the important things. Okay, fine. So